final item of business today is a member's business debate on motion number 15790 in the name of Margaret Mitchell on Hamilton Accies Exemplary Community Work. This debate will be concluded without any questions being put. I'd invite those members who wish to speak in the debate to please press the request to speak buttons now or as soon as possible. And Ms. Mitchell, if you are ready, I would call on you to open the debate. You have 7 minutes or thereby, please.
Presiding Officer, it's a particular pleasure to open this evening's debate on Hamilton's Accies Exemplary Community Work and to have the opportunity to highlight the community initiatives being championed by the club. By way of background, Hamilton Academicals, or Accies as they are known locally, was founded in 1874 by the rector and pupils of Hamilton Grammar School. In 2001, the club moved to its current grounds in New Douglas Park and it returned to the Scottish Premiership in 2014. So whilst being very much aware of Accies as the local football club, until I visited the club recently and presented certificates to the club's apprentices as part of Skills Development Scotland's Apprentice Week, I had no idea of the extent of the youth engagement, community work, and the services the club provides for the local area. So, for example, as part of the club's modern apprenticeship programme, run in conjunction with SDS, the apprentices take part in community coaching, a programme which runs 3 days a week for children and young people aged 4 to 14. This programme, coaching programme, connects with young people locally who may, for various reasons, be struggling to cope. It then provides the opportunity for the young people to access and receive support from the enterprises and organisation the club supports. Other benefits and tangible achievements which the programme provides are increased fitness, discipline, and crucially, mechanisms for coping with difficulties which the young people may be facing either at school or at home. Approximately a staggering 80 to 120 children take part in the programme each week, and they also have the opportunity to attend coaching camps in school holidays. But the activity doesn't stop there, and the in-house community outreach team oversees and helps to coordinate a diverse range of projects which are run from the grounds of the club. Members of the outreach team include Colin McGowan, George Cairns, Gary King, Lisa Kerr, Katrina McRoberts and Lynn Shaw. And I'm delighted so many of the outreach team have managed along to the Scottish Parliament to listen to tonight's debate. For it is abundantly clear to me that, as in any successful organisation, a key factor to that success is the people involved. The Hamilton Accies outreach team is living proof of this fact. So beyond the football pitch, the club houses a rich variety of community activities, including men's sheds, first launched in Aberdeen and now located in many areas of Scotland. This initiative provides a social area and place for men, many of whom have recently retired or become unemployed, to gather and enjoy male company in their local community. It also provides the opportunity to learn new skills in a workshop environment, and the Hamilton one, which is located and operated from within the stadium grounds, is the first men's shed in South Lanarkshire. Here men can try their hand at woodwork, gardening and electronics, and there's also space to play board games, share hobbies or simply socialise and enjoy the free refreshments. It is to be hoped that following the positive experience of the Hamilton Men's Shed, more will be established in South Lanarkshire. The club also works with families affected by autism. The weekly parents' carer support groups bring together a network established by the club of practitioners, third sector businesses, local charities and the NHS, in order to provide resources and support for families affected by autism. Here, once a week, parents and carers get some real respite and feel less isolated by sharing advice and from the offer of support. Furthermore, for over 8 years, the club has been running the Training for Freedom programme, which supports prisoners prior to their being released. These prisoners undertake working days at the club, which help to develop social skills and increase their self-esteem. Participation in the programme also provides useful evidence of a commitment and a desire to work when the prisoner's review is being considered by the parole board. So taking part in the programme prior to their being made eligible for parole helps these individuals reintegrate into society. Since 2011, Soldiers Off the Street Scotland has been helping ex-service personnel who become homeless. An estimated 10 to 12% of rough sleepers in the UK are British Armed Forces veterans. Here again, the club has stepped up to the plate and supports these homeless veterans in Hamilton. Finally, Presiding Officer, the football club grounds also host addiction programmes that are well known to operate throughout Scotland. These include Alcoholic Anonymous, Cocaine Anonymous, Gamblers Anonymous, Al-Anon, which is a support group for friends and families of alcoholics, Narcotics Anonymous, and the most recent addition is Families Anonymous, which supports the families and friends of those with drug addiction. With the family in mind, the Blameless charity was formed at the club to provide a space for fun and hope for the future for children and families affected by alcoholism and addiction. This charity operates from the grounds of the stadium and has facilities to accommodate our community and recovery days, open days, including festivals, play days and away days. I think the Chamber will therefore agree that the community work being carried out at Hamilton Accies is truly exceptional. Also, I consider it important to stress here where other charities have struggled to engage with those vulnerable individuals in need of support, football has acted as a hook to encouraging and actually seeing those hard-to-reach individuals take that first crucial step of walking through the club's doors to access help. There is no doubt Hamilton Accies has put in place a model of community involvement which, with the goodwill and commitment of key personnel, could, and I hope will, be replicated in football clubs across Scotland. But in the meantime, the Accies are most certainly to be congratulated.
Many thanks. Now call on Michael McMahon to be followed by Claire Adams.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. I'd like to welcome this evening's debate and congratulate Margaret Mitchell for securing it. Hamilton Academical are more than deserving of having the invaluable contribution they make to the local community in Hamilton and across South Lanarkshire recognised by having this debate. Margaret Mitchell's motion identifies the wide array of organisations which benefit from the support of the club, from self-help groups through partnership organisations with both local and national government agencies, to charities which the club has itself established in order to support a need which has been identified. There are also private companies which have facilities based in the stadium which deliver such things as employment services and other commercial enterprises which serve the wider community. The club's support for the campaign against the Scottish Government's decision to permit an incinerator to be built only a short distance away from the community of Whitehill, beside which the club itself resides, was a welcome boost to those who had been so badly let down by that decision. So all in all, Hamilton Academical are a credit to the town, regardless of whether they're proving successful on the field of play or not. As the local constituency MSP, I can state with confidence that while they may not be the biggest, they are certainly among the best at being in the lead of a community-based football club. Now, unlike Hampden, there may be no roar to greet the teams on match days on occasion. Unlike Wembley, there may be no huge app to replace the old twin towers of their former stadium. And there may be no sliding roof, as they have at the Millennium Stadium in Cardiff. But any visitor to New Douglas Park or any viewer following a game being broadcast on television cannot fail to recognise the stadium's own iconic feature. I speak, of course, about the iconic red bus, which is a permanent fixture behind the goal. The bus is used by several community groups and is now a recognisable feature within the stadium. More importantly, it's a major aspect of the club's community trust. The Hamilton Academical Community Trust allows the club to engage with many charities and local organisations and provides a suitable venue to host events, which means that the local and wider community can use the stadium and allows ever-increasing partnership working to deliver ever more partnerships between the club and the community. The Trust was created to recognise the important role that the club has within the local and wider community, and using football as a platform in which to build a close association and working relationship with many organisations across the local and wider community is a vital component of what it does. Being the only SPFL registered club within South Lanarkshire makes it uniquely placed to make that link between senior football and those who are in need. Children and young people are among those who can be most affected by the effects of addiction, abuse or poverty, and unfortunately in the community in which the club is based, there is such an existence. So it's good to know that the Accies recognise that they can use their position in the community to work with South Lanarkshire Council, the police and others to support the disadvantaged and the vulnerable through initiatives which support the community as a whole. Hamilton Accies have earned recognition for that, and I commend Margaret Mitchell for allowing us this evening to offer praise to the club's merits. Thank you.
Thanks so much. I now call on Claire Adamson, after which we'll move to closing speech from the Minister.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. Very pleased to speak in this important members' debate that Margaret Mitchell has brought to the Chamber this evening, especially as a Motherwell girl who is not often in Hamilton Football Park. I'm not a football fan at all, Presiding Officer, so I don't go very often. I'm much more of a rugby fan, but nonetheless, in my own community in Motherwell, across Scotland, I'm so aware of the wonderful work that football clubs provide and help in our communities. Indeed, I've met two Hamilton Academicals players, Michael Devlin and Gramot Kurtage, in Motherwell at Park Springs Care Home. They have FETs twice a year, and it's a very great pleasure to go along and help Nantabola like that. And I've been delighted to meet the young men from Hamilton supporting that activity in their communities and being there for people. I've also heard particularly about the wonderful work of the women's football team from my colleague Christina McKelvey. Christina had a previous engagement this evening, and I'm sure she would have wanted to speak in the debate this evening, but has had to be elsewhere. But she speaks so highly of the work that the club does in those areas. Football is such a unique way of engaging with people. I know from the Dementia Cafe that runs out of Motherwell Football Club that the links to football clubs, the loyalty, the feeling that is there is so important, and it makes it so much easier for people to engage in some of the most difficult challenges that they may be facing. And just looking through Hamilton's website, I noticed the commitment to the support of addiction programmes, particularly the Blameless charity, where they're helping children and families affected by addiction and doing as much as they can to alleviate those problems in the community. And another venture that I know that is happening across Scotland and has been gladly taken on by Hamilton is the Soldiers of the Street Scotland charity, helping those who have served their country and have come back to ensure that they have a place in society, and helping them through some of the many problems that they have. Yes, I will take an intervention.
I thank the member for taking the intervention. The Soldier of the Street Scotland one is particularly interesting because although it's based in Hamilton, there have been some interaction in my own constituency in Paisley with the individuals involved. And they've actually come over and I've seen some of the great work. They have a van where he effectively goes out throughout Scotland, and it's all voluntary led. They go throughout Scotland and they actually give the opportunity to try and trust former veterans and get them back into their van to have some food, warmth, clothing. And it's just a perfect example of something that we maybe should look at more, and using football clubs as the base, as the member already says.
Thank you. Claire Adams.
I thank George Adam for that intervention, and as a dedicated St Mirren fan, I know he is very, very close to his own football club. But I think this comes to the heart of the debate this evening, and I really do thank Margaret for bringing it this evening, is that there is that community connection there. And there's also the connection between rival fans. That can't be denied either. It's a sport that people have a passion and a love for, and it's something that can really reach out to people in the most difficult of circumstances. So I'm delighted, especially as a steel woman, shall we say, to be allowed to speak in the debate this evening, and I wish Hamilton Academicals all success in their future endeavours and working in their community.
Thanks. I now call on Minister Jamie Hepburn to close the debate and half the Government Minister 7 minutes are thereby, please.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. Can I say I'm very happy to have this opportunity to close this debate? Can I begin by joining with others and congratulating Margaret Mitchell for bringing forward this motion this evening to help not only raise the profile of Hamilton Academical Football Club generally, but especially the community work they are undertaking. Can I begin by welcoming those representatives of the club who have joined us in the public gallery this evening? Can I wish Hamilton Academical all the best for the rest of the season? Let me caveat that, President Officer. I hope that begins after Saturday when they play Partick Thistle, my own club, and I should say that's a personal view rather than an official Scottish Government position. Football is our national game, and clubs are at the heart and soul of communities throughout Scotland, be it professional clubs at the top level to the junior, amateur or youth teams that we have throughout the country. I recognise that there are issues and challenges in football. I think everyone in the chamber would be aware of that. But I also firmly believe that football is a powerful force for good. And I welcome the opportunity today to focus on the positive impact football in general and Hamilton Accies in particular is making. Sport has been shown to improve both physical and mental health, as well as bringing communities together regardless of age, gender or religion. As Minister for Sport, Health Improvement and Mental Health, I've been in the fortunate position to visit a number of clubs across the country which are cornerstones of their local community. George Adam, in his intervention on Claire Aronson a few moments ago, talked about the use of football clubs as an anchor for community activity. I have to say I was a little surprised he didn't manage to make a mention of his own club, St Mirren. It's most unlike him, but I can say to Mr Adam and other members that my clear experience of having gone round many of these clubs is that activity is already happening in many parts of the country. I'd like to take the opportunity to commend the Hamilton Accies for the services they provide, as well as allowing other bodies to have access to carry out their good work. The club's commitment, as we've heard, is wide-ranging, including addiction programmes, helping families affected by alcoholism and addiction, developing social skills and self-esteem in young people, working in the field of autism, supporting carers and men who are retired or thinking of retiring. And it's clear that commitment is genuine and long-standing and woven through the fabric of the club and its ethos. And in relation to their sporting prowess, of course, I think it wouldn't go amiss to mention their track record in developing young players and, crucially, giving them an opportunity. And that's particularly exceptional in that regard. Hamilton Accies' contribution to rehabilitating and reintegrating people with convictions back in the community is very positive. It gives prisoners approaching the end of a long sentence a chance to prepare for their release and can help them return to the community ready to be productive members of society. Both Hamilton Accies and Motherwell Football Club, and I would be the first to recognise the perilous dangers of mentioning the Steelmen in a debate in Hamilton Accies, Presiding Officer, but I think they should be included in being mentioned. They're working in partnership with the Scottish Prison Service to provide useful opportunities for prisoners to begin getting used to everyday life again by undertaking a normal daily work routine of general maintenance duties at the club. And the SPS continue to assess those involved during this time to ensure they're conducting themselves properly and demonstrating the readiness to transition to the open estate that we have in our prison system and eventually for release. The Football Fans and Training Initiative, which is run by the SPFL Trust and funded by the Scottish Government, is a hugely successful lifestyle programme originally aimed at men aged 35 and over with a waist size of 38 inches or more. We know the programme is designed to increase knowledge of diet and nutrition, improve lifestyle choices, increase physical activity amongst participants, reduce weight and waist measurements, and increase engagement in other physical activity. And I know that Hamilton Accies have used some of the funding provided by the SPFL Trust to deliver a programme with the charity Blameless, which, who have been mentioned, who are working to raise awareness of the dangers of alcohol and drugs, to educate or advance the education of alcoholism or addiction to young people and families. And this is a very welcome development and tallies very closely with the Scottish Government's wider work in this area. Indeed, I understand that my colleague, the Minister for Community Safety and Legal Affairs, Paul Wheelhouse, visited the project in January, and I know he was very impressed with the work being progressed there. As Minister with responsibility for policy regarding autism, I also very much welcome the work of Hamilton Accies in supporting people with autism, their families and carers. The Scottish Government is committed to improving the lives of people with autism and learning disabilities, their carers and families. The Scottish Strategy for Autism was launched in November 2011. It's a 10-year programme designed to meet the needs of people with autism in Scotland. Its core ambition, of course, is that people with autism should be able to participate in all aspects of community and society in which they live, work and socialise. Of course, we cannot achieve...
Michael McMahon.
Of course.
Minister for taking intervention. I recently met with the autism group myself, and Siobhan McMahon met with the autism group that meet in Hamilton Accies, and they spoke very openly about the problems that they're having, especially around transition from school to adult services. And I just wonder if there's anything that you've said in your programme which would directly support improvements in that area, because it's something I think that group in particular had identified to us as an issue.
Minister?
Well, what I would say to Mr. McMahon, I very much welcome his intervention. I think I would absolutely recognise that as with many aspects across the spectrum, the transition phase is always a difficult period, and that I know that I would be the first to concede there's probably more that we can be doing and should be doing. The strategy for autism, its core purpose is about empowering people, and I would recognise that we don't get the transition phase right for people, then we're not going to realise that ambition. So, yes, this is something that we are aware of. We're looking to do further work on. But, of course, if Mr. McMahon was wanting to contact me regarding his specific engagement with the particular project at Hamilton Accies, I'd be very happy to hear what he and they have to say. The point, of course, I was going to make, though, is that to realise our ambitions around the strategy, the Scottish Government won't be able to achieve it alone. We need others working in this area, and in that regard, it's very welcome that Hamilton Accies are involved in this work in their community. In closing, President Officer, can I thank Margaret Mitchell once more for bringing forward this topic to the Chamber, to all those who've contributed to providing such a useful and thoughtful contribution this evening, and finally, commending Hamilton Accies on their community involvement programmes. Let me assure Margaret Mitchell and those at Hamilton Accies their efforts are sincerely appreciated.
Many thanks. Thank you all. I now close this meeting of Parliament.